The pen tool can be very difficult to use at times. Especially when you try to draw these types of round drawings with the pen tool, you may have trouble some moments. In this video, I will show you an easy way to use the pen tool and you will be able to draw these oval drawings much more easily. How do we normally draw? First of all, we need to select the pen tool. To select the pen tool, you can access it with a shortcut by pressing the letter P on the keyboard. Or you can select it by clicking on this pen tool in the toolbox on the left. Now let's try to draw these drawings without using any extra features with the pen tool. Let's see what kind of results we will get. What kind of difficulties are we going to face? I start from a point, then I go through the parts that I want to draw as an oval like this. When I get here, I click and drag here again to create a curve in this part. And there is a corner here normally. The curve coming from here should continue from here with a corner. But what happens when I click here? As you can see, there is a curve. By clicking in the middle of these two lines, I make this a corner. As you can see, after this click, this is a corner and I can continue my drawing. There is a corner here again. I click on it again to turn it into a corner and continue drawing like this. There may be some problems here. We will prevent these problems from occurring with the method I will show you in a moment. And finally, I complete this line by clicking on the point I clicked on the first time. It is also possible to make small adjustments. But there can be such problems. I'm going to talk about a nice feature with the pen tool to be able to solve these problems faster, or rather to avoid these problems. If you use this method in these types of drawings, you may have to deal with these drawings in anchor point, and you may have to overcome various problems. I will not go into details. What I want to show with this drawing is that we need to do the drawings here, the slant drawings, the curves, manually. We will try to automate this. I will delete my last drawing and I redo it. But I'm doing it in a different way. I select the pen tool again and this time, instead of creating a curve, we are going to make point markings and leave the curve for later. For example, I click on the first part and then I click on the other corner. There might be a curve here. And then I'm clicking on this corner here. There is an oblique line here. So I click on this corner. And then I click on the first starting point because there is a big oblique line here. So that is how we have drawn our line. But in order to get the result you want, we need to press the Alt key on the keyboard first. When we press Alt on the keyboard, follow the cursor, you will see that the cursor changes. I'm pressing Alt on the keyboard right now. And it's become an icon like this. With this icon, I'm still pressing the Alt key from the keyboard when I hover over the line. So, you will see the curve icon. Now, to draw the oval that you see here, I press on the line with my hand, still pressing the Alt key on the keyboard, and I drag the line. I raise my hand from Alt key and we have quickly completed our oblique line without having to deal with anchor points. Now, let's quickly deal with the other parts. What did we do here? We dragged the straight line by pressing the Alt key on the keyboard and thus we were able to create oblique lines. If you want a perfect line like here, you can do these operations by selecting the direction tool in the previous logic. But as you can see, we made these oval points very quickly. This is what I want to show you. We forgot the line here. I immediately press the letter P on the keyboard, hover over the straight line, press Alt on the keyboard, and drag it. You can determine how much you want to inflate it. It becomes like an egg. But if I press the Shift key on the keyboard at the same time, it will have a more rounded shape. We don't need such a perfect roundness, so we don't use the Shift key here. And that's it for this tutorial. In this Illustrator tutorial, I showed you how we can create round shapes more effectively. That's all for this video. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.